Welcome to Karnataka LMS. So in this we are going to learn projection of planes. You have already some basic knowledge about projections, since you have learnt in projection of points and projection of lines. So here you are going to learn about the projection of planes. So what is planes? A plane is a two-dimensional object having a length and breadth only. Its thickness is always neglected. Why the thickness is neglected means, if the thickness is added, then it will become a solid part, that is a 3D part. So the best example for this projection of plane is, take a sheet of paper. The sheet of paper is a very good example of planes. For example, it is a sheet of paper is a rectangular plane. Since the A4 sheet is in a rectangular shape, we can call it as a rectangular plane. The same sheet of paper, if you cut into different shapes, then it will become a different planes. For example, the same sheet of paper, if you cut into square or pentagon or hexagons or circle, so whatever the method you use to cut, so just cut into various shapes and then you can see the different planes in that sheet of paper. Everybody has to try that example, like take a sheet of paper and cut into various shapes. It will be useful for you to analyze in the problems. So various positions of different planes in various locations. So what is this plane positions means? See, you already know about the quadrants, that is four quadrants. In this four quadrant, you are going to learn about the first quadrant only from here onwards, because you are all deal with the only with the first angle of projections. So in this first angle of projection, always the xy line will be there, and the above xy line, it will be vertical plane, and the below xy line, it will be horizontal plane. So here it will be vertical plane, and here it will be horizontal plane. As you can see here in the drawing also, this will be vertical plane and this will be horizontal plane. That plane will be rotated in this direction. So if you rotate, this will become as a plane like this. So this will be horizontal plane and this will be the vertical plane. So in this, as you can see, as the name indicates, surface of the plane parallel to the HP and perpendicular to the VP. As you can see, the square lamina or the square plane is parallel. That means you can see here, the whatever the shape of the square is there, the same shape is falling on the horizontal plane. That means it is completely parallel to the horizontal plane. But you look it from this direction, you can see here from the arrow, that will be the observer direction. If you look it from this direction, that is front view, so only you can see the edge of the line, that is edge AB. So that has been shown on the vertical plane. So you can see here, so this is the edge AB, you can see here, and in the front view, and this is the top view. So this is the top view. So this is how, if you place a lamina, it may be square or rectangle. This is only for example, we have taken the square lamina. When you go to the problems, exactly various shapes will occur. So in this square lamina, you can see there. So one, if it is parallel to one plane, definitely it will be perpendicular to the other planes. Okay. So we'll see the next configuration. Second one. You can see here what will happen. One surface is parallel to the VP and perpendicular to the HP. You can see from the previous one, and you can see the changes. The front view will be the square, that is the true shape of the square. And if you see it from the top view, you can see only the line. So this is how when the square looks like when the plane is parallel to the VP and perpendicular to the HP. So we'll see the next configuration. This is different from the previous two. How difference means, here one plane is actually perpendicular and the other plane is inclined. Okay, one plane is perpendicular and the other plane is inclined. So the parallel plane is inclined now. Perpendicular will be always remains perpendicular, but the whatever the parallel plane which we have seen the previous two, that has been converted into the inclined plane because it is making an angle of inclination with the HP. You can see here it is making an angle of inclination with the HP. So the true shape we cannot see in the front view. In the top view. So the true shape, if you see it from the top, you can see only the apparent shape. I believe you already know about the true shape and apparent shape in the projection of lines. This is very, very important. What is true shape and what is apparent shape, or apparent length or true length? This is very, very important. So the true shape you cannot see in the first position. That is, you can see here. So this is how looks like in the front view. As usual, the inclined line will be there. In the top view, the square is inclined to the HP. So this is some different method is there for solving the problem. That we'll see it in the while solving the problem. Next, surface plane is inclined to VP and perpendicular to HP. As you can see here, this plane is inclined to VP. It is making an angle of inclination to the vertical plane. And for horizontal plane, it is remains perpendicular. Since it is standing on the horizontal plane, it is remains perpendicular. This is some different position like this. If you place the vertical, sorry, if you place the plane vertical to the horizontal plane and vertical to the perpendicular, vertical to the vertical plane, so then you can see the true shape only in the side view. As you can see here, only in the side view you can see. Side view means it is a profile plane. You already know about the quadrants. So horizontal plane, vertical plane and the profile plane. So in the profile plane you can see the true shape. When you can see the true shape, when the plane is perpendicular to the both the planes, that is VP and HP, when it is perpendicular to the both the planes, so then we can see the true shape in the side view, or we can call it as profile plane. So this is when the surface of the plane is inclined to both HP and VP. This is actually the actual problem which we have solved. So this how to solve everything we can come to see when we going to study, or when we are going to learn how to solve the problem. So when it is inclined to both the planes, You can see here, this is one of the configuration. In the step one, it is perpendicular to the vertical plane and parallel to the horizontal plane. So since it is HP and this is VP and this is HP, so first position we have drawn the true shape, and the second position we have made an angle of inclination to the horizontal plane, and in the third position we have made an angle of inclination to the vertical plane. Okay, so like this we can solve the problem. So the final true shape is this, the final view. Thank you. We will continue in the next topic, which is we are going to learn about the various problems on planes. How to solve those problems, we will learn in detail. Thank you.